Good morning to all. Today we are going to study that is noise chapter. In that noise chapter we have studied all the types of sources of noise, that is the three types of source of noise we know very well. Along with that we have started, that is the internal sources of noise along with internal types of noise. Along with that internal sources of noise, there are seven types of internal sources of noise. Out of that, two types of noise we have studied, that is the first noise related to short noise and second noise is related to partition noise. Today we are going to study third type of noise, internal noise, that is a low frequency or a flicker noise. Then what is the definition or what is the terminology related to low frequency or the flicker noise? That flicker noise will be appear at the frequency below a few kilohertz. It is sometimes is called as a 1/f noise. That means low frequency noise is occurred due to few kilohertz frequencies which are came into picture related to transmission, and that type sometimes it is called as a 1/f noise. In the semiconductor devices, that flicker noise is generated due to the fluctuation in the carrier density, that is the density of electrons and holes. That means it is totally related to, again, like partition noise, it is totally dependent upon electron electron and holes, but it is totally dependent upon electrons and hole density, not arrival time of electron and hole. This is the basic difference in between short noise and that is low frequency or the flicker noise. Then the fluctuation in the carrier density will be causes that the fluctuation in the conductivity of the material, this will be produces that fluctuating voltage drop when the direct current of flow through the devices. This fluctuating voltage is called as a flicker noise. That means the directly whenever the current goes through that circuit, then that type of a noise is called as a fluctuating noise, and that flicker noise is also called as a fluctuating noise. This means the square value of the flicker noise voltage is proportional to the square of the direct current flowing through the current. That means fluctuating is directly proportional to that current flowing through that circuit. For that purpose, low frequency noise and a flicker noise is totally dependent upon current. Whichever current is flowing through that circuit, that totally current is dependent upon that low frequency or that flicker noise. This is the third point related to our internal sources of noise. Then fourth type related to our internal sources of noise, that is a thermal noise or a Johnson noise. By Johnson, it is invented, that is a thermal noise parameter. For that purpose, that thermal noise is again called as a Johnson noise. Then what is the terminology used in that thermal noise or Johnson noise we are going to study here. What is the meaning of the thermal noise? Pre-electron within a conductor are always in a random motion. That means electron flowing through that conductor is having no any kind of a fixed motion. It is moving through that random motion. This random motion is due to the thermal energy received from the distribution of this free electrons within the conductor at a given instant of a time. It is not uniform. That means the motion is totally related to random in nature. For that purpose, it is not uniform. It is moving here and there. For that purpose, it is not possible to access the number of electrons may appear at one end or at the other end of the conductor. That means where that electron occurrence, that is one end of the conductor or another end of the conductor, that is no any fixed nature related to that conductor. It is moving here and there. For that purpose, the average voltage resulting from this non-uniform distribution is zero. But the average power is not zero. Because of that, there is a presence or appearance of the conductor. There is no any power is distributed here. For that purpose, there is no any kind of a power. It is considered as a zero. As this power has appeared, that is resultant of a thermal energy, is called as a thermal noise or a flicker noise. For that purpose, the effect cannot be reduced, and the whatever the effect introduced by the thermal power, that thermal power effect is called as a thermal noise power. Then the average thermal noise power is calculated by the formula Pn is equal to KTB watts. For that purpose, here we are going to calculate the thermal power. For that purpose, power unit is in terms of watt always. For that purpose, here we have considered that is a power is measured in terms of watt. Where in this equation, we are going to use that terminology as a K, T and B. That means K is nothing but Boltzmann's constant. That means Boltzmann has defined that some thermal related power related concepts or some that is a some constant that we are going to call, that is a some constant. That constant is nothing but K is equal to Boltzmann's constant. That Boltzmann's constant is having value 1.38 into 10 raised to minus 23 joules per Kelvin. This is the parameter related to Boltzmann constant. B is nothing but bandwidth of the noise spectrum, and that bandwidth of the noise spectrum is always we are going to use in terms of hertz only. Whatever the bandwidth is given for that spectrum, we cannot use that bandwidth spectrum as it is. Then next, T is equal to temperature of the conductor, and the temperature of the conductor is converted into Kelvin. That is, degree centigrade is converted into Kelvin by adding that degree centigrade temperature along with plus 273. This equation indicates that the conductor appeared at the finite temperature can work generated of the electrical energy. The thermal noise power Pin is proportional to the noise bandwidth conductor temperature. This is all the related to that our thermal noise. Thus, in this lecture, we have studied that is a low frequency and or flicker noise. Then next is a thermal noise or Johnson noise. And these four types are converted into directly, that is a types of internal noises. Thus, we have studied in two lectures, that is a short noise, partition noise, thermal noise, and then low frequency and flicker noise. This is all the related to that our internal noise. Along with that internal noise, depending upon that thermal noise, here I have given one example related to that thermal noise, like your short noise and partition noise. That noise we are going to study here. That is, a receiver has a noise power bandwidth of 12 kilohertz. A resistor which matches with a receiver input impedance is connected across the antenna terminal. What is the noise power contributed by this resistor is the receiver bandwidth. Assume that to be a temperature that is a 30 degree centigrade. What are the data given for the calculation of Boltzmann constant and all the related to thermal noise? That is, B, bandwidth is equal to 12 kilohertz. Temperature is given, that is a 30 degree centigrade. We have to convert that 30 degree centigrade into Kelvin by adding 273 into that degree centigrade equation. For that purpose, that 30 degree centigrade plus 273 is equal to 303 degree Kelvin. This is the temperature related to that Boltzmann constant. Then we are going to calculate the noise power contributed by the resistor is given by Pin is equal to KTB is equal to what is that value of K? K is nothing but Boltzmann constant, and the constant value is a fix, that is a 1.38 into 10 raised to minus 23 into what is that value of T here given, that is a 303 degree Kelvin. Then multiplied by value of P. What is the value of B? B is having 12 kilohertz. We have to convert that Boltzmann constant B in terms of hertz only always. For that purpose, that 12 multiplied by 3. For that purpose, whatever the output came into picture by calculation of all these values, that value is a 5.01768 into 10 raised to minus 17 watt. This is all the related to that power calculated in terms of that what we are going to study, that is a thermal noise. Okay, and then along with this, we have completed our fourth type related to internal noise. Along with this, about these three types of noise are also remaining, that is a related to internal noises, that one by one we are going to study in our next lecture. Thank you.